Hey, what is going on, guys, and welcome to another old school video. So I am currently going to do the Tree Gnome Village quest, and then after that the Grand Tree, and then I can do the Monkey Madness quest, which I actually haven't completed yet, even though I am 106 combat. I just haven't really felt like I needed to, but now I do, and then after that I need to do the Legends quest, which I'm not sure if I still need another quest for that. I might, I'm not sure, but after I've completed that I should have like 130 quest points or something close to that, and then I still need like 45 quest points. So I will have to do quests that give a lot of quest points but are easy to do. Like, I don't think I've done Romeo and Juliet actually, and yeah, this one, and it gives like 5 or 6 quest points, so that's going to be an easy one to do, and then after that I can actually complete Recipe for Disaster. Okay, so here we go. This is the end of Tree Gnome Village, and then after that I'll do the Grand Tree. So if the dialogue ends, 11,000 attack experience. That is actually crazy for such an easy quest. I can imagine this being like really good for new accounts. Okay, here we go for the Grand Tree quest. I have no idea actually what the reward is. It is actually pretty good. Wow, yeah, that's a lot of agility experience actually. Did I get any levels for that? No, unfortunately not. Okay, it's time for Monkey Madness now, and this quest is going to be such a pain in the ass because I remember nothing of this quest at all, and it is a very long quest. So let's see how long this takes. I'm going to look at the time, and when I finish the quest, I'll let you guys know how long it took me to complete this as a complete noob at this quest. Okay, so I just killed the boss, and now I just need to go to the Grand Tree and turn the quest in pretty much, and it's been 1 hour and 2 minutes. So I'm probably going to finish the quest after like 1 hour and 5 minutes when I actually get to the tree. Okay, there we go. That is the quest completed in 1 hour and 4 minutes actually. But I still have to go up to Dayrond or whatever he is called to get the experience. So let's go up here. I think I'm actually very close to level in strength. Yeah, so I might actually get a strength level here. I don't actually remember exactly how much experience of each you get, but let's talk to him. And maybe you can choose, or maybe you just get it instantly. Let me see. I don't remember, so... Okay, focus on increasing strength and stamina. Okay, attack and defense. Okay, I'm close in both hit points and strength. I'm going to take that, actually. So let's see if I get levels in this. 88 hit points and 86 strength. Probably going to get 87 at least. Okay. Can I get the experience, please? What? Oh, there we go. Wait, what? Oh, I get more in those. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. So I'm 1.2k experience off from 89, and I did get 87 strength. I think that actually should be 107 combat. Yeah, that is pretty sweet, actually. So I actually have all the quest requirements done now for Recipe for Disaster, but I still need quest points, and I need 167 quest points in total, and then I will get 8 more during the quest, which is going to get me to 175, which is what you need to be able to complete the quest. So now I just need to do a couple of small quests that is going to give me as many quest points as possible, so let's get into that. Romeo and Juliet, an obvious first one to complete for 5 quest points, ridiculous amounts. I thought it would be interesting to complete the X Marks the Spot quest because that gives a beginner clue, even though they are very easy if you just wanna farm them out, but I thought, hey, I'm going to complete a beginner's clue and get 300 experience also in, I don't know, runecrafting, I guess. That's pretty neat. So yeah, I'm got 1 quest point for that only, unfortunately, but I'll complete this beginner clue and see what we get. Probably, I've seen some rewards of like 10 GP, so don't have any high hopes here. Okay then, the first beginner clue of the account. Hopefully get something that isn't worth like 10 GP here. Let's see what we get. Oh, that's actually unique. It's 32k though, so I don't really think this is worth anything at all. Yep, 34k. Hey, for a beginner clue, that's way better than I expected. Maybe I can actually get to do some more clue scrolls, because I'm going to take a break from questing now at 133 quest points, just not to get too much questing into one video, so I can spread it out over a few. And I'm going to do Hellhounds now for a Slayer task, and I might get some hard clue scrolls. And I want to do the thing again where I stack like 10 hard caskets in my bank and then open all at the same time. So I'm going to do a bit of Slayer now and just slowly stack up the hard clues. When I'm at 10, I'm going to open all of them at the same time. So I just hit 107 combat, but I'm already halfway to 108 because of these two levels. I got 84 defense and 89 hit points. Actually, I have two dark totems in the bank, so I'm going to kill two Scottiso, so I'm going to get two clues from that, and I already have one casket in the bank, so that's going to be 3 out of 10. So let's see what the loot is going to be from Scottiso. Alright, let's see what the first loot is going to be. Hopefully something good. Oh, 150 mahogany planks. Wait, that's 200k? How many ancient shards? Okay, just one ancient shard. Wait, that's actually really good, though. How much is this again? I think it said 290k. Yeah, that's a lot of money for one kill. I actually need to complete a quest called Troll Romance to be able to get this soundtrack right here. So let's just do that because I need to do quests anyways for Recipe for Disaster. That's going to be a pretty good quest to get knocked out anyways. Okay, here we go. This is the end of Troll Romance, and I unlocked the song as well. Did I get any levels for that? No, we didn't, but now I can complete that step of the hard clue at least. Another casket added to the bank. Always nice to see Dragon Plate Leg drop from Black Dragons, 160k cash right there, but this is task number 199, by the way, that I'm about to finish in 7 kills, and then after that I'm going to Konar to do the number 200 for a lot of extra Slayer points, so that's going to be very good. I actually had two Brimstone keys in my bank as well that I never used, so I'm going to do that now, but first I'll just see what assignment is going to be my number 201. 166 Hellhounds, actually. Stronghold Slayer Dungeon, yeah, that's a good one, because it's probably going to give me a lot of hard clues as well, which I want. So, let's open these and see what I get. 158 gold ore and magic logs. I think that's actually pretty good. I think that's like 120k in magic logs. Yeah, 135. And then the gold ore is not worth as much, but still pretty good, 200k. I got a clue step to go to the top of the agility pyramid, and I actually got 61 agility from that as well, so some gains there as well. I got the clue step again, where I have to have completed parts of the Legends quest, where I have to go in here. I think it's actually time for me to do this. It is a requirement anyways to be able to get in here for the Recipe for Disaster, so I might as well just do that. I'm not going to complete the Legends quest, I'm going to only do the part where I can actually access this area for future clue scrolls. I've actually got this step to get into this jungle a couple of times, but I've never done it, but it's so easy to get in here. I mean, you just have to talk to a guy and then you can get in here, so I don't know why I didn't do this before, but now it's done at least, so I can do this in the future. So I actually got another clue here where I needed a song, and that is from the Bone Voyage quest, which I need 100 museum kudos for. I only have 28 right now. I have no idea if I can get 100 right now by doing the archaeology thing or whatever, when you dig site or click the dig site specimen rocks and then you put the things you get into these cases. Maybe I will be able to get that. I get 10 each time, and I don't know how many there are or what I can get, but I'm going to try to get 100 at least. Okay, there we go. That is 103 kudos, and I also got these two experience lamps, but I don't think they will give much experience at all. Probably nothing really. Can I even see before? I'm gonna just put it in runecrafting anyways. That is... okay, 1000 runecrafting is not that bad. And how much is the second one? 1000 as well. So 2000 runecrafting experiences. It's okay. Okay, that is the Bone Voyage quest completed, which also gave me access to the Fossil Island. And I think that's where the fossil dragons are, or whatever they're called. The ancient wyverns and all that. I think they're like 70-something. Yeah, Fossil Island, wyverns, and then... I think ancient wyverns should be on this island as well, but I'm not sure. But yeah, I guess it is. Okay, there's the song, I got it, and I got the casket for that as well, but I'm just going to put it in the bank. How many do I have now? This is actually my fourth, pretty cool. So yeah, only 6 more, and then I will open all of them at the same time. Okay, look at this, 200 tasks, and I got 450 points for that. And I had like, what, almost 60 points, because now I have 516. Holy, that is so good to see. I can relax so much more now, because before I was like, I can only skip one more task, and if I get a shitty one, I kind of still have to do it. But now I can skip way more tasks again. So I'm probably going to get my casket here if I don't have to fight something. Okay, I have to fight something first, but after this I'm going to actually just open the 5 caskets that I have total after this one and hopefully get something good, because I don't want to postpone my video just because I want to get 10 hard clues and then do nothing else. So I'm going to open them after this one. Let's see if I get the casket. Should be it. Yes, there we go. Let's go open 5 caskets. Okay, here we go. This is my Slayer tab, by the way. 5.6 million. Quite nice to be able to sell that in a bit. But anyways, let's open these 5 caskets and see what I get. First one, how much money? 143k, not actually that bad. 65k, okay, that is terrible, unfortunate. 47k, okay. Come on, I want to get some profit from these clue scrolls. 398k, wow, Saradomin chaps, that is a really good one, made up for the shittier ones previously. And then 91k, okay. These hard clues were actually pretty bad. There was only one that was actually pretty good. How much did I get for all of these in total? So 750k from 5. Yeah, that is pretty good extra money. I'm going to put all of this in here and now it's at 6.3 almost. Oh yeah, I got 61 agility from that clue scroll that I did. That actually enables me to use this shortcut, which just gets me instantly to Aberrant Spectres, which is my current task. So that is actually a lot of time saved. I actually forgot I need to do Legends quest as well for Recipe for Disasters. I need to do that anyways later, but for now I'm not going to do that. I'll do that in the next video, and I just have a hard clue casket right here that we're going to open from doing Slayer. I am trying to get 83 Slayer now and I'm very close to it, so let's see what this hard clue is going to give us. Oh, that's probably very good. Let's see how much this is worth. 678k. Huge. Oh yes, 83 Slayer. I think that's the level when I can kill spiritual mages, but I'm not really interested in that anyways. But only two more levels until Abyssal Demons. I am so hyped for that. I actually completely forgot that I had another Dark Totem for a Scottish Soul kill, but I'm going to do that now, so let's see what the loot is going to be. Okay, there we go. Almost used no food for that, so that was a very clean kill. Let's see what the loot is. Oh, battle saves, 200k drop, that is very good actually. And two ancient shards, yeah, that is pretty decent. Let's do this hard clear, hopefully we can do it. It's time to get on third age. Okay, dude. 112k. It's okay, it's probably just average hard clue. But anyways, that is going to do it for this video. Hope you guys did enjoy it. And in the next one, I'm going to get Legends quest done and some other cool stuff, so... Hope you guys enjoyed this one and see you in the next one, guys. Take care.